and my beloved children. So today we have gathered here to celebrate Father's Day. First of all, I would like to offer my heartiest congratulations and happy Father's Day to all the fathers present here. This Father's Day is celebrated for honoring fatherhood and remembering the contribution, the immense contribution of father in the life of the children. The father's love and guide for the children is endless. It goes throughout the life for the child. He guides them, he educates them, and he gives them a confidence which is very, very important in order to achieve success in the life. Somebody has told, I would like to quote, that when I was a small child, my father was very strict. But when I became young and when I became self-dependent, I have grown up, then I understood that it was all to protect me. And it was all due to his love and care, because he did not want that I should commit the same mistake again and again throughout my life. So his strictness is very, very important for us to shape our future. He is, you know, he looks like from a very tough exterior, but a very, very, very soft interior. If you look at the father, you will find he is a tough exterior, but very soft interior. Inside, he is full of love and care, but outside he is very strict. And that strictness is very, very much needed in order to shape a better future of the child. And this is the reason, one of the reason maybe, that his sacrifices are not well recognized, sometimes even by the children, because he is very strict. But children do not realize when they are a small child. When they become an adult, they understand why my father was so much strict. In the same way, when a teacher is very strict, the child do not understand. Even some children do not like very strict teacher. But the moment they become adult, they understand that the strict teacher is the teacher who has shaped my future. And they become full of gratitude for the people, though you were very strict in their life. They become full of gratitude for their father. They become full of gratitude for their teacher, though you were strict in their life. If ever you want to see anything living with a very, very tough exterior and soft interior, just walk to your father and you will understand he is that kind of person. His contribution in your life is immense. He starts early in the morning from your house and comes back in the evening. Do you know why? So that he can give you a better food. He can give you a better home. He can give you a better education. This is the reason he is working day and night. So the moment you will start thinking about his contribution, the moment you will start thinking about his hard work, you will become full of gratitude to your father. And gratitude is the only thing you can repay, you can return back. In this lifetime, you will not be able to return back the contribution what the father has done in your life. But little bit, if you want to return, you can do so by just showing your gratitude, by just telling him thank you sometime and giving your love and respect. His contribution is immense. You cannot count even in your finger the kind of life you are living, the future you will be getting, everywhere he has got devotion, but it is less recognized. But still, it is endless. So the more you count, the more you get it. So I would like to inform all my beloved children that always be grateful to your father, always be grateful to your mother, always be grateful to your teacher if you want to shape your future. If you don't show gratitude to all these people, the universal energy, the energy of God, the blessing of God, also you cannot get it. So this is the day you should make a gratitude diary and note down that why should you be thankful to your father, why you should be thankful to your mother, why you should be thankful to your teacher. Make a gratitude diary that what they have contributed in your life. And if you write, you'll be shocked and surprised to see that you never thought in your life that the life which you are leading is not yours. It is contributed by somebody else. It is created by somebody else. In future, the kind of life you will lead, that too, there are many, many people have sacrificed, many, many people have contributed into it so that you get a better future, you get a happy life, you get a better kind of life. So I would like to offer my thanks and gratitude to all the father present here. I offer my thanks and gratitude to my father who is not present in this world. You are lucky that your father is with you. So feel fortunate and utilize this opportunity. Get his complete guidance. Get everything, whatever is possible, and go ahead in the journey of life and achieve success, which is only possible with the help of showing gratitude to your father, to your mother, to your teachers. I wish you all the best, children. And at the end, once again, I would like to thank all the fathers present here for their contribution in the family, for helping the children and for shaping their better future. Thank you so much. And please accept my thanks and gratitude too. Thank you.